Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making roasted red peppers and steamed green peas. And that's a combination that is red and green, and you know it's going on my Christmas table. So we'll start with roasting the red peppers. Now these are just bell peppers, but they are the red variety. And I've already cleaned them, I've washed them, and I've dried them with paper toweling. I've gotten out all the seeds and extra fibers, and I've cut them into the natural divisions that occurred in the pepper. So what I want to do is season them up a little bit and then roast them in the oven. It's just super easy. First, I need to season these up. So we're grinding a little bit of black peppercorn over the top, and then we're grinding some sea salt. And just enough for you to get some flavor there. It doesn't have to be a whole lot. And now we're going to use some extra virgin olive oil, and we're just going to drizzle it over the top. I have it in this container so that it's not going anywhere, and we'll just kind of mix this together before we put it in the oven. And I don't have any particular measure for this. Just do this to your taste. So any of these flavors. If you like a lot, put a lot. If you don't like it so much, then you don't have to. I think I'm going to be better off using my hands to get this. Over here, I have prepared a pan with a rack on the top, so it's ready to go. But if I just use my tongs, which would keep my hands clean, I think I'm going to lose a lot that I could actually rub in. And that's not only the olive oil, but also the salt and pepper. Is just kind of sticking there or going to the bottom, but we'll rub it in a little bit. So I have these peppers all coated, and I'm just going to spread them out. It doesn't really matter which side you put up. I do have my tongs waiting so that I can just turn these over at any point. These will be going to a 400 degree oven, and I'm going to place them a little above center. So they'll be a little closer to the broiler in case I decide to switch to broil, because I do want to get a nice sear on these. Everybody expects roasted peppers to have a little bit of blackness, but not burned. So what we're going to do is put the rest of this, even though it's probably not going to stick, instead of just wasting it, I want to drizzle it over the top and hope that it helps a little bit. I should have curved them up the other way if I wanted to do this. But there we go. This goes to the oven, and then I'll be back when it's done. We've roasted our red peppers, and this is what they look like. And this is exactly the look that I was going for, because you expect to see a little black here and there. It's nice and seared, and that makes it a very mellow taste. What I did was to use 10 minutes on each side, baking at 400 degrees. Then I turned it to broil with the convex side up and gave it a minute or so. Since these are done, I'm going to go ahead and take them up. And if all you want out of this recipe is the roasting of red bell peppers, then you're done. Just put them in a serving plate. Now I'm going to kind of fan mine out a little bit, because I'm going to be doing some steamed green peas. And this will make a lovely presentation for our steamed green peas. I'm ready to make the peas that go with our dish. And I have a pound here, and I've already started pouring them in here, but I wanted to show you that what I have is a pot that has just a little bit of water in the bottom that is boiling, providing steam to come up so I can use this steamer. This steamer is called the Steamy, and some of you have seen me use it in Betty's Kitchen before. So it's going to make that kind of full, but these will expand a little bit, but I think it will hold them, and they will stay nice and green. And I'll be able to check them and find out when they're tender, and that's when I will bring them up and put them on top of our roasted red bell pepper. We're ready to put our steamed green peas in with our roasted red bell pepper. So you can see what this looks like. These are nice and green. They're steaming, they're hot, they're going to be luscious, and you really don't want to overcook them. So I find the best way of getting them done and perfect is to use a steamer. But if you don't have one, you can boil them in water and then just take as many as you would like for this particular dish. It's kind of unpredictable as to what size bowl you might be using and how you want it to display, but we're getting about to the point where I would maybe stop on putting this in my presentation because I don't want to cover up these beautiful roasted red peppers. So here it is. This is our finished dish. Roasted red peppers and steamed green peas. I hope you love it. I'm going to take a little bite of the peas. I don't think I'll go to the trouble of getting the roasted red pepper because it's going to be some trouble to get off. And our guests are arriving any minute now, so I need to get this on the table. This is something that you probably need to do on the day of serving it. So here we go with the two little peas. And as you would expect, they're delicious. Hope you love it.